Chapter 32, In the Long Run. In Buddhism, meditation practice is sometimes compared to mountain climbing. At first, the ascent, hard, grueling, and painful as we struggle and strive. Then, the plateau, long, flat, and boring, demanding patience and perseverance. And finally, the descent, quick and easy, gaining momentum as we cheerfully expect return. In the beginning of practice, we fight with crazy mind, bogged down in muddy doubts and self-pity, and we don't even know if we are meditating. After the struggle, which may take many years, we settle down and for the first time can truly enjoy some peace and quiet, a silent mind. This is the great middle, like a plateau, during which time the practice matures and refines into our own unique expression. Here we gain character and skill, learning advanced navigation in spirit on the still seas of mind. Finally, at the last stage, we start to hurtle towards our source, towards forever, dissolving apparently endless fixed notions and patterns of feeling into a boundless condition that defies all description, ultimately laced with bliss. At this point, as Ra would say, quote, the looking backwards is finished. Descending the mountain of self-mastery, we leave behind the ages of our dreamscape of evolution, the ancient illusory sense of separation and needing work to do. For myself, as I suspect for most self-aware wanderers, life on Earth today is like the middle phase of meditation. We are here for the long run, and the 3D journey is far from over. And like the plateau stage in meditation, dealing with day-to-day life in 3D demands patience and perseverance. Every day we must get out of bed, brush our teeth, wash and dry and clothe our body, then go on to meet the many tasks that we have chosen. If you sometimes feel fatigued, know that you're not alone. I know lots of wanderers and spiritually minded folks who are ready to get back onto the bus going back home. Weariness is common. Of course, this is also well known to non-ET servers and seekers. Nevertheless, countless little doings required by life on Earth are the matrix of our maturity as souls. It's like personal counseling once the stormy seas of emotional crises are past. Only then can self-revelation really begin. In the first phase of meditation, a time of struggling with the wild mind, we have no idea what spirit really is. It's only after we've cleared and risen above the fog that we can begin to see the path we're already treading. Spiritual maturity really depends on altitude. And after we've gained some altitude, the next challenge is staying with it. Again, this is the long run. The efforts required post-crisis to make it work. The slow growth of character, attitude, and purpose. In meditation, it means long sitting in silence with a tamed mind. For wanderers, it means long-term adjustment to 3D life in a confused, materialistic society. And for all who serve and lend a hand, it means the slow refinement of skill in knowing how, when, why, and who to serve. In the long run, we as souls gain durability, patience, and fortitude. As for my own recent experience, having flown over 80,000 miles in 1997 for teaching and counseling, I was relieved to have the next few years for more self-reflection and inner travels. During this time, I've taken a long, hard look at the issue of quality versus quantity, the relation between effort expended and harvest achieved. I've come to realize that there's little value in running around to serve or to promoting my work to those still unsure of their needs. Since only self-awakened self, to run around urgently seeking the chance to teach is definitely an unbalanced approach. If we can take each step slow and easy, whether we're in the ascent or the plateau or nearing descent, then we can remain sensitive enough to make the various inner changes demanded by the time and thus preserve our harmony with those around us. The balanced way in meditation takes us from silence and non-doing to active engagement in service and then back again. Like the ebb and flow of a great ocean, following our path in harmony with self and others brings grace and respect for the cycles of change. In the long run, the only thing we can really depend on is spiritual balance. The next chapter continues our discussion of meditation.